Hello everyone, in this video we have one circle and one semicircle, and then here is given 6 units, and here is given 8 units, and here is 2, and then these are tangent point and x is asked. Okay. First step, notice that if here is 6 units, that means here must be equal 6 units, right? Why? Because of 2 tangent theorem. Likewise, if here is x, this length must be equal x unit. And then, notice that here, according to 2 tangent theorem, these two parts must be equal, right? So let's call A, these two equal parts. And if you focus on this blue point, we can apply power of a point theorem, right? Therefore, 2 times this part a plus x must be equal this length 8 times this length 6 plus a, right? Okay, let's simplify the expression. So a times x equal 24 plus 4a, that means x equal 24 plus 3a, right? Okay, this is the first equation. And then, if you connect these two corners, here must be equal 90 degrees, right? Because it is opposite of the diameter. Okay, and then this side, I want to represent with y for this triangle. If we apply Pythagorean theorem, h squared plus y squared equal a plus x whole squared. Right? Okay. Therefore, y squared equal a times x whole squared minus 64. This is the second equation. Okay. And then if you focus on the biggest triangle, we can also apply Pythagorean theorem for this triangle. So y squared plus this length 14 plus a whole squared equal this length 6 plus x whole squared. So y squared equal 6 plus x whole squared minus 14 plus a whole squared. This is the third equation. Notice that second and third equation are equal. Therefore, if we equalize these two equations, so a plus x whole squared minus 64 equal 6 plus x whole squared minus 14 plus a whole squared. Let's organize the equation. If we move this term right side of the equation, and let's move this term left side of the equation, that means a plus x whole squared plus 14 plus a whole squared equal 6 plus x whole squared plus 64. Therefore, a squared plus 2ax plus x squared plus 196 plus 28a plus a squared equal 36 plus 12x plus x squared plus 64. And then these are again a squared, 2a squared, and 28a, 2ax. We know that x equals 24 plus 3a, right? So 2a times 24 plus 3a, and 96 equal 12x. We know that x equal 24 plus 3a, right? Okay. And then 2a squared plus 28a, let's distribute. 48a plus 6a squared plus 96 equal 288 plus 36a, right? Okay. And then 2a squared plus 6a squared equals 8a squared, and plus 40a minus 192 equals 0, right? And then if you divide by 8 both sides of the equation, that means a squared plus 5a minus 24 equals 0. And if you factorize minus 24 as 8 and minus 3, so a minus 3 times a plus 8 equals 0. Therefore, a equals 3 and a equals negative 8. We know that length can't be negative. That means a is going to be 3 units. Therefore, if a equals 3 units, that means x is going to be 33 units. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe to my channel. Wow.